love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Andy, the video game reviewer, and today we're going to be reviewing Overlord, brought to you in part by Triumph Studios, the makers of the Age of Wonders series, and undoubtedly a few other games. Unlike a lot of games that have been out lately, Overlord actually puts you in command of a number of minions. So rather than just being a hulking evil dude with an axe going around chopping up stuff, you actually have a ton of these little guys right here going around kicking other people's butts for you. So the majority of the work is actually managing them, and which isn't that really hard. They basically follow you around and do your bidding, and you click and it sends them out. You click, right click, and you bring out your Horn of Gondor and summon them back, and they come running back with basically from loot and treasure, and sometimes even pumpkins stuck on their head because they're stupid and you're cruel and you can do anything you want. What I was most impressed with was the fact that the townspeople enjoyed having you around. You protect them from the evil creatures like sheep, wild sheep, eating all of the food in their farms, and the evil, cruel, despicable hobbits. The hobbits that are pillaging their village and taking over the poor farmer's pumpkin farm. They actually took him and crucified him on a big plank of wood and made him be a scarecrow. So he gives you your first quest to rescue his pumpkin patch from the goblins. So what do? You trample all the pumpkins. I tell you, this is an absolutely wonderful game. Inside, we have our discs for it. We have the Overlord CD right here. And there, so you can see your nice big hulking Overlord. Yes, that's you. Here, on the inside, we have the following. We have an Overlord map of the world drawn up by your goblin minions, and we have, of course, the strategy guide. All in all, it's pretty good. It could be worse. In terms of gameplay and graphics, I already said left-click sends your minions, right-click brings them back. So that way they're not going out and getting destroyed by ranged fire from the stupid halflings upon towers. All in all, I'd say this is game probably gets like about an 8 out of 10 just from not playing it but having seen it played for about 15 minutes, half hour, something like that. I definitely plan on getting my own copy installed as soon as possible and also having all my other friends install that and begin using it. Tremendous fun. And the graphics are very reminiscent of Guild Wars and World of Warcraft. It's a little more on the cartoony side, which I happen to like. I'm not a fan of the pure, awesome realism games. This is just enough cartooniness to it that it's fun to play. It adds to the fantasy, to the lighthearted evil and destruction. By the way, this game, you are evil. You're not good. You're not a misunderstood bad guy. You are evil. You're relishing in it. They wake you up by putting acid in your eyes to clear them of some of the fogginess, as they've brought you back to life. You're brought out of a crypt, so you're obviously like a Ringwraith or Sauron or something like that. It's fun. It is fun. It is fun, fun, fun.
Overlord. A game to end all games. Quite literally, since your ultimate goal is the destruction and domination of the entire world, and what you can't dominate and destroy must be cleansed and polluted and corrupted to make it more evil. Hi, I'm Andy.
What is it?
And this is my cat.
Tired of you.
These are my whelps that I smack and smack and smack some more. And when I get tired of that, sometimes I bring forth my minions and we begin pillaging the countryside. Look at the horde. Aren't they happy? There's Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, and Blitzen. And do you recall the most famous minion of all? Why, it's Adolf, the red-nosed goblin. Anyway, you kill sheep, you steal parts of their life force, and that lets you summon more minions. Basically, your soul stealing them. Not necessarily the nicest thing, but hey, you didn't get to be Overlord by being nice, did you? I didn't think so.
What's this?
Burn, burn, burn.
My land.
burning ring
not
of fire.
Burn, baby. Burn.
It's fun. Just setting everything on
you
fire.
Out of the way,
watch the little
man.
Guy on the right. help me! Help me! I'm on fire! I'm on fire! Help me!
Oh
good. That tree
fire.
Put it out by absorbing the fire. So, you send the minions out to kill him. Absolute fun. Absolute fun. Also, as your little minions kill stuff, they bring back whatever they gets left behind, whether it be souls, items, potions, or most especially, gold. As you can see, I already have several hundred gold pieces lined up, and that's not from killing anything all that difficult. That's just looting and pillaging a couple of treasure chests and whatever happened to be on the as pocket change for most of the creatures of this world. Also, you can get the allegiance of certain towns. They join your forces, and they're extremely happy to see you. Yes, destroy the barrels that were blocking the trade routes of the town, so that way more mules and more goods and services can go through the gates to the city. Also, you can get your guys drunk and have them blow up more stuff, and just
attack,
a lot of
attack.
Fun. Absolutely a lot of fun.
Attack them. Slay the hobbits.
Sometimes they kill for pleasure, sometimes they kill for gain, but always, 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 they do what I say, or I will kill them and sacrifice them.